Welcome into this place. Welcome into this broken vessel you desire to abide in the praise.
Thank you. God a hand clap of praise. Let's give God a hand clap of praise. Yes, we are in the sanctuary this morning, and my God, it's been a while since we've been here, musicians. Upper Room's been a minute since we've been here, and it's just a few of us, and we want to thank God for allowing us to come and lift up the name of Jesus this morning. Well, let's go ahead and do what we've been doing over the last couple of months. Let's get ready for the Word of God. That way you all can enjoy your Sunday morning. I know you got great plans for the day, and so we don't want to hold you up any longer than we have to. Let's bow our heads right where you're at in your home. Eternal God, we thank you right now for this day. We give you glory and honor. We just thank you for blessing us to be into your house of praise this morning. It's been several months, Lord, and we say thank you for the covering of your blood over our life. Now, Lord, as the musicians and the upper room staff and myself get ready to worship you, we ask that, Father God, you use us in a mighty way, that we rightly divide your word, and that all we say and all we do, you get the glory and the honor. Forgive us of all our sins. And Lord, we just thank you right now for the move of your Holy Spirit that will take place today in this place like never before, that souls will be saved across the land, saints will be revived across the land, and backsliders will come back to you across the land. It's in Jesus' name we pray, and all of God's children this say amen. This morning, as we come to lift up the name of Jesus, to give him all the praise, all the glory, for what a mighty God we serve. Well, I invite you this morning, once again, my brothers and sisters, as we go back to the Old Testament, and we shall focus on Zechariah this morning. Once again, Zechariah chapter 4. Zechariah chapter 4, musicians. Zechariah chapter 4, upper room. And we want to focus on verse 6 once again as we continue to preach from where we left off last week. Verse 6, let's read that together. It's been a while since I've been able to turn back and look at it like this, musicians. But Zechariah chapter 4, verse 6, it reads as following. Then he answered and spake unto me, saying, this is the word of the Lord unto Zerubbabel, saying, not by might nor by power, but by my spirit, said the Lord of hosts. I want to talk with you, those who are part of Facebook, those who are part of YouTube, those who have called in by way of audio. I want to talk, musician, upper room, I want to talk from this subject. It's not me, but God, part two. It's not me, man. It's not me. It's not me. Die. It's not me, Adam, but it's God. It's not me, Carlton. It's not me, Jonathan, but it's God. Here we find here this morning, my brothers and sisters, not to hold you long, but here we find in our text, once again, this morning, we find a man named Zerubbabel. He was the governor of Judea, Zerubbabel. In his state, as we stated last week, my brothers and sisters, he was given what I have come to the conclusion of, an impossible task. In other words, he was given an impossible task. Assignment. And the question I want to ask musician, the question I want to ask upper room, have you ever been in a situation where it seemed like God himself have given you an impossible task, an impossible assignment where you just didn't know how you was going to do it? You see, during the time of Zechariah, when he pens this, my brother and sister, many of the Jews were returning back from Babylonian captivity at this time. There was a time where they was captive, and yet here they are, my brothers and sisters, they have been given the task of rebuilding the temple. And here it is, the temple had been destroyed back in Jerusalem by the Babylonians, and the Jewish people were captive somewhere around 586 B.C. I think I'm going to teach this morning, my brothers and sisters. And I want to ask the question, the same question I asked last week. Have you been in a situation where it seemed like your own life was full of pieces? If you've been in a situation in your own life where it's full of rubbish, where you didn't know how you're going to make it, you had no idea in your life how you was going to put your life back together again. I'm sorry. You didn't know how you was going to put the temple back together again. And finally, my brothers and sisters, we asked the question last week before we left. We asked this question, what do you do when you're faced with an opposition? What do you do, Di, when you face with an impossible task? How do you make it through a pandemic? How do you, my brothers and sisters, go through your trying situation in your own life? And we discovered last week from just point number one, my brothers and sisters, only point number one we was able to cover last week. And point number one, we said, you have to allow God to encourage you. I got some walking room this morning. You have to allow God to encourage you, regardless of where you at in your home, whether you're traveling in your vehicle. I just want you to repeat after me, allow God to encourage you. For the Bible said in verse 6, then he answered and spake unto me, saying, this is the word of the Lord unto Zerubbabel. And for the sake of time, my brothers and sisters, because I know they want to get back to what they need to do this Sunday morning, so for the sake of time, allow me to just go right into point number two this morning, my brothers and sisters. So not only do we see here that if you're going to be faced with opposition, not only do we see if you're faced with an impossible task that you allow God to encourage you, but point number two, my brothers and sisters, I feel like preaching already. Point number two, you have to allow God to equip you. So not only do we allow God to encourage us, but point number two, we allow God to equip you. Listen what the text said here, right here, Zechariah chapter 4, verse 6. We still in the text. Then he answered and spake unto me, saying, this is the word of the Lord unto Zerubbabel. That's point number one. He allowed God to encourage him. But then here's the equipment part right here. This is how God will equip you. This is how God equipped Zerubbabel. In the text, he says, saying, not by might nor by power, but by my spirit, says the Lord of hosts. Brother and sister, when God gives you an assignment, he always provides everything you need to accomplish it. And I know it's sometimes in our own life, we don't see, it don't look like God is in the midst. It don't look like God is giving us the equipment that we need. It don't look like God will equip us to get through our trying situation. But my brothers and sisters, you have to allow God, not man, but allow God to equip you. Question, is there anything in your life that you need God to equip you with? Oh, I can be honest with you. There's many times in my life that, if the truth be told, that when you look at this text, it's dealing with the mountain, and here it is, my brothers and sisters. It seemed like life would bring mountains into our own life. What do you do when you're faced with a mountain? What do you do? Notice the text. Notice what the prophet equate the job of building the temple. He equates it as a mountain before him. Can I go on and teach? And here, my brother and sister, if we're going to keep it 100 this morning, regardless of where you're at, if we're going to keep it 100 this morning, I want to let you know we all at some time or another face a mountain. I don't care how saved you are. I don't care how things going well in your life. We all face some mountains. And notice the text again, in regards of how God will equip us. Yeah, I know Zerubbabel is in the text. I know Zechariah is in the text, but I need to talk to us this morning, because it's us who need to know how God will equip us. Look at the text, because the question I asked myself, how would he accomplish this impossible task of rebuilding the temple. And here it is, my brother and sister. First thing I notice here, if he was going to build a temple from God, the first thing I notice is it's not about your might. If you're going to rebuild a temple of what God has for you in your own life, it's not about your might. Listen to the verse here, the last clause saying, not by might. Not by might, Adam. Not by might, die. Not by might, man. But he said, but watch this, not by might. Now I'm looking at that word. Let me pretend my deacon's over here for a second. I was looking at that word. No, ain't in here. I'm sorry. I was looking at that word might. Watch this. That word might comes from a Hebrew word, teach, dodge, somewhat, and it means somewhat as a military term. I think I'm going to teach as a military term because, watch this, 56 times when they use the word might in the Bible, it's used as an army. Oh, I'm going to teach to you. Watch this. 37 times it's used as man of valor. Watch this. 29 times it's used as a host. So it's used as a military term, but the same word, yeah, it comes from a root word that paints the picture, my brothers and sisters, to be force. It means to have a lot of men behind you. It means resources. And so the text is really telling us, it's telling Zerubbabel that if you're going to rebuild the temple, it's not about your resources. I wish I had some help in here. It's not about the men. It's not about the people, but it's about God. And can I go a little bit further with this word might? Because this word might also suggests the idea of an army. It also suggests the idea of wealth, virtue, strength. Watch this. The ability or substance. In other words, the temple is not going to be rebuilt by the people pulling their collective strength together. I don't care how many members you have. I don't care how many people that say they're on your team. I don't care how many people call themselves backing you up, my brother and sister. There comes a time you got to understand you cannot depend fully on men. And so the question I ask myself, die. Have you ever experienced a time in your life where you had enough manpower, you had enough resources, but the job still didn't get done? Oh, I think I'm act like I'm talking to the saints over here on the right side of me. We're going to pretend it's a bubble as the NBA. We serve and worship the Lord in a bubble this morning. And so watch this. Have you ever been in a situation in your own life where it seemed like you had enough money to get it done, but money just couldn't do it? You had enough people supporting you, but you still couldn't get it done. And so it is, my brothers and sisters, I want to tell you, this is a good time in your life to understand that, yes, it's good to have resources, but it's better to have God. And so it is. So it is. You, my brothers and sisters, is not by our might. Watch the text. Watch the text. He said, it's not about your might. The second thing he tells us, if we're going to be equipped by God, he lets us know it's not about our power. Good God Almighty. It's not about our power. Watch the text. Still in the last clause of the verse, verse 6, he starts off once again. He said, then he answered and spake unto me, saying, this is the word of the Lord unto Zerubbabel, saying, not by might. We understand that. But watch this. Nor by power. I love this word, power. Teach, Dodge. I love it because it comes from original language, watch this, where we get our English word strength from. He said it's not by, won't be by your strength. And it gives the idea, watch this, it paints the picture of, watch this, a person with the capacity that has the means to produce, to make things happen. And he said, it's not by your strength. Which suggests to me, and refers to the individual's strength. In other words, my brothers and sisters, the temple was not going to be rebuilt by Zerubbabel's, watch this, master engineering. Teach, Dodge. It wasn't about his strategy. It wasn't about his skills or his ability to be able to have one's craftsmanship to build the temple. Was that pretty good right there? And the question I had to ask myself, if God is not going to use Zerubbabel's might to rebuild the temple, if God is not going to use Zerubbabel's power to rebuild the temple, then how will he rebuild it? The text says right here, by his spirit. Now that threw me, Adam, by his spirit. That threw me by his spirit. Man, that threw me because in the natural, I'm saying the only way the building can be rebuilt is with some strength that we can see. Good God Almighty. When last time you seen the spirit? And so I was trying to figure out how could the spirit rebuild the temple if the might couldn't do it and the power couldn't do it. And I had to do some research. Yes, I did, Annie. Y'all had to do some research. And I found out when you look at this word spirit, yeah, I almost missed it. Almost missed something in the text. And the Holy Spirit told me that I almost missed the underlying process of what was taking place. What was taking place? The Bible said that it was about the rebuilding of the temple. He had to receive the word from God to rebuild the temple. Which suggests to me that if God was going to build a temple, rebuild the temple, God had to be in the midst of the building. But here's the part I missed, almost missed, because he wants them to rebuild the temple. Let me break it down. He wants them to rebuild the temple. He said, watch this. I know what you did before, watch this, with your might. I know what you did before with your power, but this time it's about my spirit. Which suggests to me, I'm just talking to me for a minute, would suggest to me that the same God that was with you when you built it by might, the same God that was with you when you built it by power, the same God will be with you today. Can I tell somebody who's going through some stuff, the same God that was with you last year, before COVID-19, y'all want to teach, though? The same God will be with you today. For I heard the Bible said here in Zechariah chapter 4, verse 6. Now, I'm about to go home. When I say go home, I'm going home for real this time. Watch this. Zechariah chapter 4, verse 6. Then he answered and spake unto me. He's saying, watch this. This is the word of the Lord unto Zerubbabel, saying, not by might, nor by power, but by the Spirit, says the Lord of hosts. And so it is, the Spirit of God would move on the heart of Zerubbabel. He would move in his life, in his service, in order for God to accomplish this impossible task before Zerubbabel. Yes, I want to ask someone this question. Are you allowing the Holy Spirit to direct you in rebuilding your temple? So it is. This Bible that we believe in can always give us what we need. And here it is in the text. The Bible told us last week that there was a a bowl on top of the lampstand. And there was, yes, the tree on both sides of the lampstand. And the oil was flowing inside the bowl. Yes, and symbolizes that the light will always be burning. And what I found out, my brothers and sisters, in this short lifespan, yes, we all need the Lord. Yes, to lead us by His Holy Spirit. And I'm reminded, of an old hymn, yes, from my young days. Oh, Lord, and that same song, it asked the question that I want to ask you this morning. Yes, Lord, have you any rivers? I feel like preaching. That seems uncrossable. Yes, have you any mountains that you cannot tunnel through? The good news, hey, come on, y'all. I say the good news. God, yeah, specializes in things that seems impossible, and He will do. I'm a witness this morning. What no other God and what no other person can do. Oh, Lord, there's no power. There's no might like the Holy Spirit. God will specialize. And can't you see the Holy Spirit this morning walking through the life of Zerubbabel? Can't you see he needed some assurance because the construction of the temple, yeah, it has ceased. Can't you see the people had grown discouraged because tremendously politicians was trying to rule the land? Can't you see the same people that started the project have not stopped the project? But all you know, God will send you what you need at the right time. And I'm glad this morning I know the Holy Spirit will show up and show out. I heard Paul said in Ephesians chapter 3 verse 16, Paul said that he would grant unto you according to his riches of his glory. Paul saying, be strengthened with his mind by the Spirit in a inner man. I believe I'll preach, y'all. I heard Paul saying in Philippians chapter 2, verse 13, for it is God which worketh in you both. It is God who will give you what you need. I gotta leave you now, but before I leave, is there anybody who know the Lord and you don't mind saying this morning, it's not me, but it's God, the same one that woke me up this morning? It is God, the same one that clothed me
in my right mind, it is God, the same one that feeds me when I'm hungry, the same one that give me shelter over my head, the same one that gives me the ability to make some money, but most of all, he's the same one that died over 3,000 years ago. He's the same one that they allowed him to march up Calvary's Hill. I say the same one. But oh, when he got there, he said not a mumbling word. When he got there, they hung him high and stretched him low, stretched him wide. And you know what happened. You know what happened. You know what happened. You out there on Facebook land, you know what happened. You out there on YouTube this morning, you know what happened. And somebody said, what happened, Dodge? I'm glad you asked. What happened? He died. Yes, he did. And they buried him in a borrowed tomb. But early, let's go home, y'all. Early, let's go home now. Early, one Sunday morning, he rose with all power. All power. All power. It's not me. It's not me. But it's God. Man, I ain't walked down these steps in so long, I hope I don't fall, but it's not me. But it's God. Somebody need to know that this morning. You're struggling, you're going through some stuff. You're trying your best to figure out on Facebook. You're trying to figure out on YouTube. You're trying to figure out by way of audio how I'm going to make it. The good news that we want to tell you on behalf of Antio, we want to tell you on behalf of this ministry that we serve a God that would give you the strength that you need in order to make it. Bible said, I never seen the righteous forsaken, nor have I seen his seed beg for bread. Whoever you are this morning, if you don't know him, regardless of where you at, you can get to know him today. And you can know without a doubt, it's not you, but it's God. All heads bowed wherever you at, and I just want you to pray with me, along with me. Repeat after me, dear Lord, thank you for this day. Thank you for your grace. Thank you for your mercy. I come this morning asking that you will forgive me of all my sins, that you would cleanse me right now. I confess to you that I am a sinner, but I want to be saved. And only you can save me this morning. So, Father God, I confess right now that you are God, and besides thee, there is no other. Father, you said in your word, if I confess with my mouth, believe in my heart that God has raised his son from the dead, I shall be saved. I confess it. I believe it right now. And I know I'm saved. And for that reason, Lord, I thank you for the move of your Holy Spirit upon my heart right now to give my life to you. If that prayer was for you, regardless of where you at this morning, Facebook, YouTube, audio, wherever you at, you too can be saved. We thank you. We bless God's holy name this morning. Oh, man. Oh, my. Say it's not me. Say it's not me. But it's you, Lord. And we give you all the praise. Say we give you all the glory. For another day, another day. So we just say thank you. In Jesus' name. And all of God's children did say amen. Come on, let's give God a hand clap of praise wherever you're at this morning. We pray that something has been said to help you, to encourage you, regardless of what you're going through. It's not you, but it's him. It's not by your might. It's not by your power, but it's by his Holy Spirit, said the Lord of hosts. Well, let's get ready to give back to the Lord this morning by way of our tithes and offering. As the Lord has blessed you this past week, you know he has blessed you. Why don't you be a blessing back to the ministry as we here at Antioch continue to try to do the will of God for the upbuilding of his kingdom here. So there's still things that we're doing here at Antioch. We still need your help. We still need your resources. And so we ask that you would be obedient to the Holy Spirit by way of giving back to him by way of tithes and offering. We have several ways that you can give, as you know, for us giving your tithes and offering. Number one, you can drop it off at the church. There's a secure location for you that's local. You can do that. Second thing you can do, my brothers and sisters, you can mail it, your tithes and offering, in to the church P.O. Box. That's 1614 Carrollton, Georgia, 30112. You can do that. Thirdly, my brothers and sisters, you can use the push pay that we have that's available. Regardless of what where you at, you can use that. So use that device on your mobile device, or however you want to do it, to do the tithes and offering by way of push pay. And the push pay name is Antioch Clem, Antioch Clem. Make sure you use that Clem, because there's a lot of Antiochs, and we want to make sure it come to Clem. Ain't that right, musician? We want to make sure it come to little Clem. And then the fourth way, my brothers and sisters, those who want to support the ministry, what I do on a personal level by way of trying to spread the gospel here and there and doing what all I can do throughout the community. We here at Antioch have set up, and I want to thank Antioch for setting up a love offering for me. And we ask for your support. I really do. I ask for your support by way of giving the love offering if you desire. You're not forced to do it, but we ask that if you can, send a seed offering. If you don't mind, you can send it to my personal Cash App, if you don't mind. You can also use the push pay. The personal Cash App is Vincent Gerald Dorch. The dollar sign is in front. And I want to say thank you so much from the depth of my heart for your support. Well, we pray that something been said once again. We thank you so much, Antioch. Thank you so much, guests, for tuning in. My God, I enjoyed being back in this pulpit. Yes, I did. Well, yes, I did. I felt good. Can I preach again? All right. I don't know if I can do on crazy dances now, but anyway, we thank God for you all. Upper Room, Deacon Carlton, Deacon Jonathan, thank you for your time to come out to make sure we had our sound right. Thank you so much in making sure that we can have everything ready to be a blessing to the people. And musician, thank you all so much. You all are the best. Thank you so much for your dedication and all that you do. What you got? What you got? Come on, rock it for me. Rock it. Yeah. All right. That's how we're going to do it. Yeah. Oh, give thanks. Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. Oh, my. Come on, one more time. Yes. All right. God bless you all. Let's get ready to go. Once again, we thank you. All hands raised up towards heaven. Stand to your feet wherever you're at. I know you're at home trying to relax.
Son, don't go to sleep while I'm talking. Hey, hey, hey. Don't you lay your head back. I'm important. I'm somebody. Now, you might do your English teacher that way, but I'm not teaching English. I'm teaching eternal life here. I love you. You know I love you. Have I convinced you I love you? You better nod your head yes. All right, come on, put it right there. All right, you stay awake and you listen to me. You say, well, he may never come back. Well, he ain't here now. And where have you been, Mr. Underwood? And I noticed on the calendar I'm supposed to marry y'all. What makes you think I'd marry you? You're one of the sorriest church members I have. You're not worth 15 cents. And you want me to marry you to her? And you want to marry him? And he don't even know where he belongs? And you don't even know where you belong? Now, let me tell y'all, everybody here, how much I love these kids. Do you know I love you, sir? Stand up, big boy. Do you know I love you? Mm-hmm. All right. All right, give me a little love. I'm a real deal. Yeah. All right, I know you are too, but you ain't been here. Now, y'all don't want me. All you got to do is tell me. We won't have a church fight because I'll get my little Connie and we'll get in her little Buick Enclave. It's paid for. And we'll sell what we need to sell. And we'll go on down the road and we'll find some little podunk church that don't know up from down. And I'll find me a dozen Joe's Baskets who don't have a pot or a window and who will shout Jesus. And I'll give the rest of my life to them. Are y'all keeping the camera on me back there in the little video room? Good. We're having trouble in the video room. There's no one finer than young Cox back there. And he comes down here and spends hours in that thing. But he has a little attitude adjustment that we're going to fix. Brother Cox, you listening? Because Brother Cox, I can fix your attitude adjustment. And I don't care what your mama thinks and your daddy thinks. And I don't have a better friend than your mama. But mama, you get out of my way when I'm messing with that boy. Because I'm his preacher. I'm yours when I'm talking to you. But I'm his when I'm talking to him. And last I checked, he's a grown man. And that video room ain't going to be a youth hangout. We might as well just fix this thing. And I don't know what I'm doing wrong. Well, if you don't know what you're doing wrong, son, you don't care about what I want to do right. Because if you loved me and you submitted to me, you'd know what my heart is and my message is, and you wouldn't go about establishing your own kingdom in the video room. I really feel good now.
I said I wasn't going to say nothing. But y'all about to get on my nerves. Y'all really are. Church is canceled. Church is canceled. Please do not reach out unto me. Do not reach out unto me. And I know a lot of y'all want to gather cyberly, your cyberly gathering. That's fine. Please do not send me an invitation. I will not be in attendance. They say when two or three are gathered, I am gathered already, guys. Me, myself, and I, we're gathered. Okay? I don't know why y'all cyberly gathering. You can't touch and agree on nothing because it ain't no touching. You ain't supposed to be touching one another. So now y'all just agreeing. Y'all all cyberly gathering, agreeing. Just know whatever y'all believing for, I'm believing with y'all, okay? Know that I'm believing with y'all.
Stuck in the house again today. The devil knows he's a liar. I stay inside because it's not a game. Rona set my plans on fire. Before the day I met you, we could go outside. You're the source of this world locked down. And I just can't deal. I just can't deal. I just can't deal with this thing called Rona. Rona. Then they shut all the schools down. All childcare was canceled. The kids are loose and running wild. No teachers here to tame them. Then I got some schoolwork I ain't seen in a while. I'm about the 4th grade with my child, and I just can't deal. I just can't deal. I just can't deal with this thing called Rona. Rona. Oh, Rona, you got to leave. Because of you, they keep us locked up inside. Ooh, stay far away from me. Every day we're praying that you would leave. Cause we just can't deal. We just can't deal. We just can't deal with this thing called Rona.
Well, once again, Annie, I pray that you all have enjoyed the laughter, but most importantly, I pray that you have enjoyed the message over the last 2 weeks. It's not me, but it's God. And I pray that you be encouraged throughout this week. Annie, y'all, don't forget, we'll be having a church meeting on Wednesday at the 7 o'clock hour via Zoom as well as GoTo. So please tune in. I'll send you all the information that you need. Have a blessed week and enjoy your rest of your day. God bless you and I love you. Take care.